Hey and welcome to the Wood Grafter. Today in the shop we're going to talk about bench dogs. I've got some of the leading ones on the market. We're going to put them through their paces. That sounds interesting. Stick around. Welcome to the Wood Grafter. My name's Andy Guile, and if you're new here, welcome. Our mission at the Wood Grafter is to inspire, educate and support you in your journey to becoming a better woodworker. Here on the YouTube channel, we do that through a whole series of videos. We do tool reviews, we do tool tips, setup reviews, simple projects that you can complete in a weekend, and generally come together for a jolly old chat. We've also got a companion website, www.thewoodgrafter.com, and over there you'll find blogs, information, a vibrant community, and more details step by step how to do something, all course based. So if you're not a subscriber here, subscribe now, leave me a thumbs up, drop a comment in, I always reply to each and every one. And if you're not on the website, get over there now and grab yourself a free membership. With that said, let's talk about dogs. I think bench dogs are one of the most versatile tools you can have in your workshop, especially like me and many of us if you use an MFT style table. Anything that's got the grid of 20mm holes in that we rely for speed, repeatability and accuracy in our woodworking. Now in this video I'm going to look at a few different types of dogs. I'm going to look at the very, very cheap and cheerful generic dogs, such as these black ones here. This type of dog with the flat face inside it, these are made by Festool, but Veritas do a very, very similar version. The slightly higher end version of these, such as these Veritas Parf dogs. More modern creation, such as these Parf Super dogs. And the Quad dogs from benchdogs.co.uk. Now bench dogs aren't a new thing. They seem to be coming back into vogue as more and more people use this style of workbench, but they've been around for a long time and their purpose hasn't really changed over the years. You can still get them for your hand tool workbench, and this one has been knocking around, in fact one of four that knock around on my hand tool bench, and I've had these for years, and you can see they're the same sort of idea, the modern day interpretation. They're round, they fit into a 20mm hole, they've got a grip at the top and they've got a friction spring at the side. Now these are designed to go into a 4-inch thick worktop, which is exactly what I've got in my workbench, and they do the same sort of job. If you're not familiar with what dogs do, in their simplest form they allow you to push a piece of wood against them. Why, you may ask? Let's have a look. On any material, on any project, you're going to find times where you need to work on the face of your material, the edge of your material, and the end of your material. And bench dogs make that incredibly easy. Throw a couple of bench dogs in here, and that's it. And I can now push against those. Now, if I want to play across the grain, I can do that quite easily, and those bench dogs make a very, very nice planing stop. A simple clamp at this side can push against those dogs, and that is now nice and firm. Allow me to quickly come in with a hand tool and start doing some chiseling work. So all in all, nice and easy. So why therefore have we now got such a big variety if these super cheap ones will do the job? Well, it all comes down to accuracy in your work. And if all you want to do is to use them as a brace to push a piece of wood against, these cheap plastic ones that you can find in different sizes in many, many woodworking shops are ideal for it. But they all have a slight flaw in their design, that they move. You see those moving inside the slots. Now that movement becomes a problem when you're looking for more accuracy in your work. And like many people, if you want to use the accurate 20mm grid in your workbench to make sure that you're going to get accurate cuts by using some sort of system like that, then that potential movement in these dogs can knock your accuracy out, taking you away from 90 degrees. Now, to have that movement, most dogs have a thread in the bottom, a standard M8 thread, and that takes one of the many knobs that you can buy in the marketplace. Now where that adds advantage is you can clamp that down from underneath the workbench. Now that makes a super secure position, and there's no way that that's going to move. Now although that works and makes a super secure foundation, the problem with that is you're always interrupting your workflow to get down, to undo the knob, to tighten the knob, to readjust these. So what you really want is something that is super, super quick to readjust, doesn't move around in the holes so you get that accuracy, and doesn't interrupt your workflow. Now that's where these more modern types of dogs come in, and I have two here that do a similar sort of job. I've got the Quad Dog from benchdogs.co.uk, and I have the Parf Super Dog from my friends over at Axminster. And you can see they're a similar sort of idea. They both have stainless steel bodies, and they both have these two rubber rings. And what happens is, you loosen that off, insert that into your 20 millimeter hole, so both rings are inside your bench, and then simply tighten up. And without going underneath your bench, that has now give you a nice firm foundation to work from. And this one works in exactly the same way. Into the bench, tighten it up, and gives you a nice firm foundation. And they both do the job incredibly well, and I can't pull those out. Now the Parf dogs sit in the middle, somewhere between the cheap plastic ones and these more modern ones. And these are really, really good when you're using track saws. They slot into a 20 millimeter hole. The collar stops from going into the bench. The wood can sit against those collars. And then the track saw rests against those things there. Now these also have that same problem in this movement inside the dogs that can knock off your accuracy. So even with this new design, you still need some sort of knob to tighten it up. So let's look at these two more modern devices. Now both of these work in the same way. You can see there's a threaded portion inside the dog, and that basically is putting pressure on these two rubber grommets when you tighten it up. And obviously as you put pressure on those rubber grommets, they expand in this direction. So that sits inside the hole, a couple of twists, and that's now locked into your bench. The more you twist, the tighter that lock becomes. Excellent. On the Quad Dogs, this is one solid piece of stainless steel, and you just twist that entire thing together. On the Super Dogs, they're a bit more complicated. If you look inside here, you get a central screw, you get an outside sleeve, you get a small collet, you've then got the portion that's got your little grommets on it, and then an end cap. And this center ring here, you can change depending on what you want to do. So the configuration that I initially had it in is to give me a smooth barrel, smooth 20 millimeter barrel, all the way down. Like so. Now the kit comes with two other rings that fit into this central location. There's a wider ring that starts to give it exactly the same configuration as this Parf dog, and a much narrower ring that rests inside the 20mm hole, giving it a little bit more stability and also stopping the dog falling through the bench when you're unfastening it. And to change that, it's simply a matter of taking off the bottom assembly, taking off your ring, putting on the new ring, and tighten up again. Now that's quite a useful little feature. So even with this all loose, that doesn't fall through the bench. And as you can see with the Quad Dog, with that loose, that will quite happily fall through the bench. And in my case, normally falls out into the wood bin that sits underneath this bench. Now the problem with that, of course, is it sits slightly proud of the surface. So when you bring your material in, if you're not careful, you can rest on the outside of this ring, or it can slip over and rest on the dog itself. And that's going to give you inaccuracies in your work. But there's a solution for that. I'm not sure if you can see or not, but this has got a slight chamfer in this direction. And you can buy a small tool that will chamfer the top of the 20mm hole. So when that's inserted, that will now sit flush to your bench and it will remove that inaccuracy. So that's quite a neat little solution if you can be bothered to go around and chamfer the tops of all your holes. Now the slightly larger collar gives us the same functionality as the Parf Dog, but with one key advantage, and I'm sure you can already see what that advantage is. So just put that together. Okay, so now that slots into the hole. It doesn't go through the bench because that collar's stopping it. I can now tighten that down as I would normally. Now I've got all the advantages of a path dog in that my stock can reference against these base collars. My rail can reference against the dog itself. I can still use a clip to hold that into place, but this doesn't have the movement in that this does. So very, very accurate, very, very quick to use, and I don't have to mess about underneath the table clamping this one in and out. So I think that's really, really cool as a feature. Now, whether you need all these, I think really depends on your situation. For me, I just tend to use this in this 20mm smooth configuration because I find there's enough resistance on those orange washers anyway for that not to slip through the bench as I tighten it up. So in the Parth Super Dog system, you get the Parth Super Dog, you get three collars, the 20mm one, the recessed one, and the slightly wider one as well. Now these come in two lengths. The one that you can see here is a 90mm Super Dog. This bottom portion is 30mm that goes into the bench, so it gives you 60mm usable height on that dog. They do a second dog that's 120mm long, exactly the same design, in fact exactly the same base. Now that will obviously give you 90mm of workable height on top, and they all come with the various parts we see here. Now the quad dogs are called quad dogs because they have four components. The actual long body itself, they have the top assembly with the black washer on it, a small bush, and a bottom piece. This is known as the base assembly, and you can buy this base assembly separate, and then you can buy multiple lengths of these. And in fact, I think Ralph will do you a custom service where you can buy this in whichever length you want to. Just check out his website. So this is actually ultimately variable depending on your situation, which is cool. Now the standard length this comes in is a 12mm one, a 20mm one, a 30mm one, and this one here that's a 60mm one. Now this is a much simpler design, and there's none of those additional bits on it, and I actually find that for my uses slightly better. And I put it in there, and I find I can get much more grip on this than I can on the Super Dog. And I find this gives me a much more secure fit in the workbench. Now I find these easier to take in and easier to take out of the bench. The rubber here is slightly softer on the Super Dogs, or obviously this black rubber is slightly harder. And I find that that can catch a little bit on the bench. And I'm already beginning to see wear on this top rubber here as I take that in and out of the bench, and it tends to catch and deform. With this being harder, I'm not seeing that same amount of wear, and I've used this one much more than I've used this one. So I think I'm going to get more longevity out of this harder rubber washer than this softer rubber washer. Now this must be a common problem because both of these dogs come with additional rubber grommets. So I imagine that these do wear over time, and you can actually buy these from Axminster, and you can buy these directly from benchdogs.co.uk. So they are a disposable, replaceable item. Now in terms of manufacturing, very, very similar. They're all made out of high quality stainless steel. They both use compression of the rings to tighten into the 20mm holes. The Parth Super Dog is heavier than the Quad Dog. I'm not sure that makes any difference, but it's noticeably heavier. I'd say it's about 50% the weight of the Quad Dog. And in use, and in this configuration, they do the same thing. Slightly different to insert. You put this one into the bench, slide down that rubber, hold the middle piece, and then you just turn this knob at the top, and that's now compressed those rings. This one, bang into the table, and just turn the dog, and that compresses the rings. I find I can get much more torque on the Quad Dog than I can on the Super Dog. And what that means, although it's very minute, there is less movement if you do push hard on the quad dog than there is on the super dog. And you've got to make sure you are clamping this thing down to stop that movement, where this, it's a no-brainer, and it just sits in, turn it, and it's locked in every time, and there's very little movement inside that dog, where on this one, I still have movement. Now, I'm not sure that's going to affect my workmanship much, but I could see a situation where, referencing against the dogs, that one there could move ever so slightly, and that could knock my work off by a small fraction, which in my shop would not be acceptable. Now, these are a variation on a theme. They're both dogs. These are made by Festool, but Veritas do a very, very similar set at much less money. And these are made of aluminium. And again, they've got the M8 hole in the bottom. The difference is that they have a flat face machined on it. Idea is, flat faces, referenced very well, against a flat surface. Personally, I don't find that any difference than referencing a flat face against two round surfaces. There's no difference in its clamping ability that I have ever found. So whether these are of value to you, I guess, is really up to you. I could see a situation, if I clamp that down underneath, that it's going to give me a better single reference point than a round one, but I don't tend to work in that way anyway. So although I have these, they came in a set from Festool, I'm not sure that's something I would rush out and buy. A set of four of these plastic ones, if you can find them, it seems to be harder to find these than it used to be, but you can still get them. A pack of four of this size is probably going to cost you somewhere around about £10, so very, very cheap. The slightly longer ones, same material, the hard plastic, are probably going to rush you somewhere around about £14 for a set of four. The flat face ones, Veritas, not these Festool ones, they're £15 for a pair. Now, buying the Parf dogs, these are about £18 for this size, which is a 70mm size, but they do a smaller one that's 10mm high, that's about £12. Now, that's £12 for a set of two. The super dogs come in two lengths. This is the 90mm one, and that one is going to cost you £25. The longer one, the 120mm one, is going to cost you £29.95, so nearly £30 for the long super dog. The quad dogs are slightly different when you buy them. You buy the base separately, and the base is going to cost you £10.20. But that base will then work on the full range of quad dogs. And they come in at 12mm for £7.80, 20mm, £8.40, 30mm, £8.70, and this one, 60mm, £9.30. And again, that's for one. So to buy the setup I've got here, the 60mm, with the base, will be £19.50. And when you contrast that to the Superdog at £24.95, then this one actually represents better value. Assuming that, like me, you don't have a use for those two rings. It's no surprises, in my shop, I've gone for the quad dogs. I also have a lot of these black plastic ones just knocking around the shop that are quick and easy to grab. And if they get damaged by a tool, then I don't really care. But for precision work, I use the quad dogs every single time. They're a relatively good price point. They're well machined. They've got no frills on that I don't need, so I'm not paying for anything that's not important to me. And they do the job. Now, you can also buy them in a set in one of these nice mini sustainers. Ralph over at Bench Dogs call this the fully loaded set. As sold, this is what you get in the fully loaded sustainer. Two of the 60mm, two of the 30mm, two of the 20mm, and two of the 12mm, and two bases. Buying that set in that configuration will cost you about £99, including the sustainer and the insert. And I also went ahead and I bought additional bases, because eventually I'll have all these lined up in a dog kennel I'm going to build in a future episode, and therefore they'll always be ready to go and always close at hand. So if you fully load up the fully loaded sustainer with the additional bases, this is going to rush you about £160. And that sounds a lot, but the precision and the value that I'm going to get out of that, speed of use, accuracy of use in my workflow, it was well worth the investment. Now, just for information, all the dogs that you've seen on this video, I bought myself. So there's no sponsorship in this video. Nobody sent me anything free of charge. Therefore, I'm free to make my own decision. And my decision has gone clearly with a benchdogs.co.uk fully loaded quad dog set. What you do is up to you. But I hope it's been of use. And with that, I'll see you next time.